this morning.
Back at the Olympic pool and ready now for the start of the men's 200-meter freestyle final. An opportunity to see for the first time a young man who could become one of the biggest individual stars of these games. There's his name, Mikhail Gross, the Federal Republic of Germany. He's from Frankfurt. He is the world record holder and world champion in this event. His primary challenger is Mike Heath of the United States. But Gross, 20 years old, is the first swimmer since Mark Spitz to hold simultaneously the world records in the 200-meter freestyle and the 200-meter butterfly. He is known as the albatross. A single distinguishing feature, the long arms, 90 inches from fingertip to fingertip, a body Mark Spitz built for swimming.
It definitely is built for swimming. He gives the illusion when he swims, Jim, as actually having a small turnover, or slow turnover, that is. But that's only an illusion. He has a lot of thrust, a lot of power out of those arms, and you need to keep that power going to keep the speed going.
He will be swimming in lane four and is the favorite to win the gold medal in this event. In qualifying earlier this morning, he was nearly 0.7 seconds ahead of world record pace after 100 meters, and then either slowed down or tied. There is Peter Dale of Australia, who will be swimming in lane one, biggest surprise qualifier. Lane two, great story. Jeff Float, 24 years old from Sacramento, California, captain of the American team. Not to belabor the point, Jeff Float is 80% deaf in one ear, 60% deaf in the other, and has the genuine admiration of every other member of the United States Olympic swimming team. Lane three, Thomas Farner of also West Germany. He will be swimming next to his teammate, Mikhail Gross. Just one of several outstanding freestyle swimmers in that country right now. There is Gross as he gets ready to step up on the blocks in lane four. He appeared in perfect position to break his world record in qualifying. Whether he tired in the last 50 meters or simply slowed down to conserve energy, we may find out pretty soon. Lane five, Mikey, the American record holder in the event, 19 years old from Dallas, Texas, and the University of Florida. He set the American record at the United States Olympic Trials in June. He's the second man ever under 1 minute 48 seconds in the event. The other, of course, is Gross. And next to Heath in lane six is a teammate of his from the University of Florida, 19-year-old Alberto Maestre of Venezuela. He was second in the Pan Am Games last year behind an American swimmer named Bruce Hayes, one of many outstanding American freestylers for whom there is no room in this event, as only two American swimmers qualify to swim in each event. Lane seven, Frank Drost of Holland, another of the surprise finalists. He's never even been able to make the final in the European Championships, but here he is in the Olympic pool swimming the final. And in lane eight, Marco Dell'Uomo of Italy, who is 22 years old and was dragged along by Michael Gross, or Mikhail Gross, I should say, in his heat to qualify for this final. The world record in the event is 1:47.55. The American record is 1:47.92. That is Mikhail Gross on the left, Mike Heath of the United States on the right. There was a time before qualifying this morning, Mark Spitz, when I thought Heath might have a shot at upsetting Mikhail Gross in this event. Man, I'm not sure I believe that now.
And nothing's final until you finish on the wall, and I think that he still has a chance. Mikhail Gross needs to set a fast pace, and normally the pace in a 200 meters freestyle is done in the first 75 meters, the first lap and a half.
As we watch Mikhail Gross go out to the lead, keep in mind that just as American swimmers did not swim in Moscow in 1980, so too did the swimmers of the Federal Republic of Germany find themselves subject to their nations joining into the boycott of those games. Gross touches at 50 meters in 25.70. That is relatively fast, and he is well ahead of the rest of the field. Heath swimming in a relaxed fashion next to him in lane five, and the second place swimmer right now is Alberto Maestre of Venezuela in lane six.
Right now, when they come into the 100 meter mark, he has to make small adjustments in this next 50 meters that he's going to do, the next third lap right here, because if he's going to start to think about an a world record time, he's going to have to start making his move. In the freestyle, you must, if you want to start the sprint, start about 25 meters in advance because there's sort of a lag time there to build up the inertia from the tremendous power that you're creating in your stroke. I think there's no question right now, Jim, that he's going to win this race. The big question is whether or not he's going to go under 147.55, his world record. This is going to be a big day for West Germany.
He's a little bit off of world record pace as he comes back now in the last 50 meters. But unlike this morning when he was slowing up at this point, he is beginning to try to pick up the tempo a little bit. Mike Heath has moved into second place, and Heath is moving up and trying to solidify second place at this point. And as they come down to the wall, remember the time to watch is 1:47.55. That is Gross's world record.
Unofficially,
in 1:47.44, he did it with a blistering last 50 meters. Mikhail Gross of West Germany has broken his own world record in the 200-meter freestyle. And Mike Heath of the United States has nailed down second place and a silver medal. Jeff Float of the United States just missed third place. He finished fourth in the race.
The Games of the 23rd Olympiad. Brought to you by...
...of the Federal Republic of Germany, 20 years old, 6 feet 7. He's won a gold medal and set a world record. For the Federal Republic of Germany. It already is apparent, I think, or certainly first indications are, that these are really going to be a quality Olympics. We've had two world records in